Hello, Matlang people! Welcome sa It's No Time! Claim the learning, hashtag learn together!
Maraming anyong lupa at tubig na nakikilala dahil sa kanilang mga hugis o itsura. Isa na rito ay ang Laguna Lake, na hugis animo'y tinapakan ng isang malaking manok. Ang Mount Mayon na kilala dahil sa kanyang perfect symmetrical cone shape. At ang Bulkang Taal na itinuturing nating pinakamaliit na bulkan dito sa Pilipinas.
Mount Makiling is a dormant volcano in the province of Laguna. Ito rin ang rason kung bakit maraming hot spring at geothermal power plants ang makikita sa paanan nito.
Ang bundok na ito ay nakilala dahil sa hugis nito na parang nakahigang babae na pinaniniwalaang si Maria Makiling.
Ano nga bang pag-uusapan natin sa araw na to?
Understanding the normal curve distribution. So these are the most essential learning competencies for this topic. For our target goals, number 1, illustrate normal curve distribution. Number 2, know the properties of a normal curve distribution. And number 3, value the knowledge about the concept of normal curve distribution. So for our review, let's have the steps in solving the variance. So first step is to find the mean of the probability distribution. Second step, multiply the square of the value of the random variable x by its corresponding probability. So in symbol, we have x squared times p of x. Third step, get the sum of the result obtained in step 2. So pag-a-add din lang natin lahat ng mga results na nakuha natin from the step 2. And for our last step is to subtract the square of the mean from the results obtained in step 3. So isusubtract lang natin yung result na nakuha natin sa step 3 doon sa square ng ating mean. So in symbols, we have summation of x squared times p of x minus mu squared. So in able for us to get the standard deviation, all we have to do is just to get the square root sa ating variance. Now let's define the normal curve distribution. So pag sinabi nating normal curve distribution, it is a probability distribution that is symmetric about the mean. Or kapag hinati natin sa gitna, ay it will form two equal or two mirror parts, showing that data near the mean are more frequent in occurrence than data far from the mean. So yung ating pong mean sa normal curve distribution or normal probability distribution ay 0 at ang standard deviation naman is 1. So let's try to visualize a normal distribution. So let's graph this or graph the frequency polygon of the following scores of 7 students in math quiz. So yung ating 1 and 2 dito siya makikita. Yan, plot natin. 2 and 4. We have 2 and 4. And then 3, 5. 3 and 5. 4, 7. 4 and 7. 5, 5. So dito natin makikita ang 5, 5. 6, 4. And 7, 2. And then kapag pinag-connect natin yan, as we can see is makikita natin yung parang bell shape or yung pabundok na shape ng ating graph. And it is symmetric about its center or about its mean. Yung mean natin dito is yung, ayan, yung linya ng 4. In reality, if a distribution consists of a very large number of cases and the three measures of averages, the mean, median, mode are equal, then the distribution is symmetrical and the skewness is 0. Ngayon, let's have the properties of a normal probability distribution. So, as just like what I've said, nag-form tayo ng bell shape. Because yung first property niya is the distribution curve is bell shape. Next, the curve is symmetrical about its center. The mean, median, and the mode consigned at the center. The width of the curve is determined by the standard deviation of the distribution. So, yung pagitan ng scores na makikita natin dito sa ating graph or sa ating curve ay dinedetermined by the standard deviation. And since ang our standard deviation is 1 sa isang normal probability distribution and the mean is 0, so mag-start tayo sa 0, then 1, then 2, then plus 1, 3. Dito naman to the left, minus 1,
The negative 1 minus 1 is we have negative 2. Negative 2 minus 1 is negative 3. So, ganito po ang itsura ng ating normal probability distribution or normal curve. The tails of the curve flatten out indefinitely along the horizontal axis, always approaching to the axis but never touching it. So, kahit na gaano kahaba yung end ng ating curve, hindi niya matatouch yung ating horizontal axis. And the area of the curve is always equal to 1. So, the standard normal curve is a normal probability distribution that is most commonly used as a model for inferential statistics. The equation that describes a normal curve is this one. Ayan po. So, by substituting the mean 0 and the standard deviation 1 in the formula, mathematicians are able to find areas under the normal curve. Fortunately, these have already been determined for our use. The area between negative 3 and positive 3 is almost 100%. Bakit almost 100%? Because the curve almost touches the horizontal line. Pero hindi pa rin siya or not yet 100%. And now, let's have the empirical rule. So, ang empirical rule is also known as 68, 95, and 99.7%. Ang sinasabi lang dito, class, is from negative 1 to 1, ang kanyang area is 68%. Negative 2 to 2, we have 95%. Negative 3 to 3, we got 99.7%. So, itong 34% na to, hinati lang sa dalawa itong negative 1 and 1. So, 0 to 1, we got 34%. 0 to negative 1, 34%, and so on. Saan pa natin pwedeng magagamit tong empirical rule? So, suppose we will find the area of the following scores based on the given below. So, for our mean, we have 60 and standard deviation is 5. Diba yung mean natin ay makikita sa gitna? So, dito sa gitna natin, dito natin ilalagay yung 60. And then, standard deviation is 5. Pagitan ng bawat scores natin ay 5. So, we got 60 plus 5, 65. 65 plus 5, 70. 70 plus 5, 75. To the left naman, minus 5 tayo. 60 minus 5, we got 55. 55 minus 5 is 50 and 45. So, ito yung magiging itsura ng ating normal curve kapag ang mean natin is 60 and standard deviation is 5. Ngayon, let's try to look for the area below 60. So, pag sinabi natin below 60, starting here up to 45. Below, kasi mas mababa daw sa 60. So, let's just add 34%, 13.5%, and 2.35%. So, kapag pinag-add natin lahat, ang sagot is 49.85%. So, it means, class, that 49.85% of the scores ay nasa below 60. Between 50 and 70. So, we got 50 and 70. So, pag-a-add din lang ulit natin yung mga areas na nasa loob ng 50 to 70 scores. So, we got 61%. How about between 60 and 65? So, as we can see, it is 34%. Greater than 65? So, 65 to 75, so we got 13.5 and 2.35%. So, we got 15.85%. And lastly, below 70. Ayan. So, from 13.5 up to 2.35, pag-add din lang po natin, so we got 97.35%. So, that's how the empirical rule works. For generalization, class, normal curve distribution is a probability distribution na merong mean na 0 and standard deviation na 1. And it is symmetrical to its center. Properties, the distribution curve is bell-shaped. The curve is symmetrical about its center. The mean, median, and the mode coincide at the center. The width of the curve is determined by the standard deviation. The tails of the curve flatten out indefinitely along the horizontal axis, but it never touching it. And the area of the curve is 1. And the value that we can get from this lesson, a smile, is a curve that makes everything straight. So, always smile.
Alam nyo ba na ang Mount Makiling ay nagbibigay ng isang mahalagang balanse sa ekolohiya ng lalawigan. Ito ang nagsisilbing santuwaryo ng mga ilahas na hayop at pinipigilan nito ang pagbuho ng mga lupa.
Ito ay mahalaga ring imbaka ng tubig na pinagmumula ng mga natural na bukal ng mainit na tubig para sa mga pook paliguan na isang pangunahing atraksyon at malaking negosyo sa Laguna.
At dito na nagtatapos ang ating aralin. Ibahagi natin sa ibang ating mga natutunan. At lagi nating tatandaan, the way of success is the continuous pursuit of knowledge. Claim it, Matlang People. See you again sa ating next video.